giving you an opportunity to get the full story from the people who tell it best. This is Mediacom News Leaders.
I'm Don West, and this is Mediacom News Leaders. I'm joined now by Brandy Harris, the new CEO of the Boys and Girls Clubs of Springfield. Brandy, welcome to you.
Thank you so much for having me, Don. I'm very grateful to be here.
You just started the 1st of April, replacing a legendary figure in Pat Gartland.
Yes, yesterday was my first day, and honestly, I am still kind of on cloud nine, but I had the unique opportunity to shadow Pat Gartland for 2 months, and not many new CEOs can say that they have that opportunity. So I was like as ready as I possibly could be yesterday. I'm very excited.
So the title is CEO now. It's always been executive director at the Boys and Girls Clubs dating back to Bill Henderson.
Absolutely.
What's the difference now?
Honestly, I think the name is the only thing that changes. I think both names mean the same thing, but in the Boys and Girls Club movement, a lot of organizations are kind of moving towards the title of CEO because they want people to also understand that we're a business. Like, we're a nonprofit, but we also have a ship to run. So that's the title. But for me, it's the same. Basically, you're just the leader, the visionary of the organization, and you try your best to have a team of warriors around you to take things to the next level. That's what it is for me.
And we want to introduce you today. What is your background? Where are you from?
Oh, goodness. Okay. So I am from Springfield. It was the first place that I was like able to call home before I moved to Springfield in 1999 for my 8th grade year. I attended 13 different schools.
Oh, my.
Yeah. So when I came to Springfield, something was different about this town. It was like, it was the first constant, the first stability for me. So I became a Reed Beaver, a Hillcrest Hornet, a Drury Panther, and then I got my master's at Missouri State, so I'm also a Bear. My heart is in this city. When I graduated college in 2008 from Drury, I became a teacher at my alma mater, Hillcrest High School, which was a very unique experience and so wonderful because I automatically had a support system. My former teachers were now my peers, and they were ready and willing to help make sure that I was successful. And then I moved to Lawrence, Kansas because my husband was getting his PhD at KU. And yes, I am a Jayhawk fan, which I'm very nervous to say. I'm sure people are now like questioning if I can lead an organization, but I promise you I can. And when you move to Lawrence, it's just in your blood, right? When you move to Lawrence, you become a Jayhawk. Uh-huh. So I thought I was just going to continue teaching, but the truth is I couldn't find a job. I applied for 62 different jobs, and that's not an exaggeration.
Wow.
And the Boys and Girls Club called me, and they said, we want you to be our AmeriCorps staff, and we're going to pay you $300 a month. And I said, okay, yeah, a little bit more. That's a little more than nothing, so I'll take the job. And then the rest is history. I realized that the Boys and Girls Club was all the best parts of teaching for me. I realized I had a place there, and I told myself, I'm going to be running a Boys and Girls Club soon because that's what I want to do. Ideally, I want to do it in Springfield. And now I'm doing it at 32.
And were you a club kid?
I wasn't. Honestly, that's a big motivation for my vision, is that I feel like I could have benefited from the club so much growing up, but I didn't know about it. So a part of my vision is to expose what we do for kids and ensure that all kids have access to us if they need us. And what I'm learning is that all kids need you. They just need you in different ways. And the Boys and Girls Club is able to meet the needs of so many different kids. So
there are so many great things that the club does, and there are fundraisers that go on constantly, at least one a month, it seems like. And that's a lot to take on.
A lot to take on. But here's something I kind of learned the hard way. I always used to think that leadership was like, you have to know everything. And then I learned that if you're the smartest person in the room, to find another room and surround yourself with people who play to your weaknesses, surround yourself with a team of warriors who will work tirelessly for kids, because I cannot do this on my own. And I'm so grateful that I have a team of people who are ready to take this club to the next level and who are ready to work every single day as hard as they can for kids. That's incredible. And I intend to expand that team and to take over the city one club at a time.
Four great units in Springfield with the Boys and Girls Clubs and a new leader now, Brandy Harris, as the new Chief Executive Officer of the Boys and Girls Clubs of Springfield. bgclubspringfield.org is the website to find out all the information you need about this great organization. We've had some great leaders, Brandy, with Bill Henderson and Tom Huff and Bill Stalnicker, and then Pat Gartland for the last 17 years. I have no doubt you're going to carry the torch just fine, and congratulations.
Thank you so much.
And join us next time here on Mediacom News Leaders.